Maybe you were an underachiever in life. Good news, because thanks to modern science, you can finally accomplish something more than a sick 360 no-scope Call of Duty headshot while living in your parents' basement. All you have to do is die, and if you're really lucky, you'll end up helping the US military out. Humans have hacked other humans apart for a variety of fun reasons since we left the trees in Africa for the open savannas. Typically, our primary reason was war, or just plain old-fashioned murder. But one day, several thousand years ago, the first true medical students got an idea. What if we hacked the human body apart so we could learn how to put it back together again? Sort of. And just like that, the science of anatomy was born. Some of the ancient people who would put the knowledge of anatomy to best use were the Egyptians, who had a variety of shockingly advanced surgical treatments for various ailments. Sadly, primitive medical knowledge still meant most of these patients died anyway, mostly because humans had yet to discover the concept of washing one's hands before shoving them inside the intestines of another. But ancient Egyptians' anatomical expertise was of even better use when you're dead, as they skillfully sliced open corpses to remove and preserve organs during mummification in order to help prevent decay. The science of anatomy would have little effect on improving the lives of the living for several thousand more years, however, when it exploded in popularity during the late 18th century and early 19th century. Empiricism led to the establishment of what we'd today call modern scientific methods, and this required research and experimentation, a lot of it. There was just one problem for the budding anatomist. They needed bodies to work on, and families were extremely frowny-face about handing over loved ones to be mutilated in front of an audience. Some donated bodies were received from time to time, but doctors faced yet another problem. People were taking an almost obscene amount of time to die. If you were healthy, you might even live as long as 25 before dying to cholera, or in a horrifying industrial accident, or in Europe's favorite pastime, war. Surgeons circumvented the lack of bodies by simply stealing them. Other less scrupulous surgeons gladly paid others for donated bodies which they knew were being robbed from freshly dug graves. Often doctors would even turn a blind eye to very obvious murder victims. Such was the hunger for bodies to experiment on. Eventually, the government decided enough poor people had been murdered and sold to medical schools and changed the law to allow only donations. This law stands until today in most nations. But what exactly happens when you donate your body to science? Well, first of all, not just anyone can donate their body to science. There are various concerns over the risks your body might pose even after you vacated it. On your quest to become an elaborate prop in some medical student's freshman prank, you'll first have to undergo a screening while still alive. The screening will dive deep into your medical history and include blood work to test you for every disease under the sun. As you'll soon be in the hands of bumbling first-year medical students who won't know your ass from a hole in the ground, there's a serious concern about accidentally contaminating those working on your body. Conditions such as HIV, AIDS, hepatitis B or C, COVID-19, and other highly contagious diseases are an automatic disqualifier, as is being severely overweight or underweight, though occasionally there are special requests for obese donations in order to test new medical devices. That's right, your body won't just go to be clumsily hacked apart by medical students, but could be used to test new medical devices. Testing new medical technology inside living humans is morally challenging due to possible unforeseen malfunctions or unintended consequences. Surgeons, however, also have to learn how to implant the latest doohickey inside a still-living person that will hopefully remain still-living after the procedure. And that's where your chump corpse comes in. Surprisingly though, age doesn't matter when it comes to body donation. Even if you're extremely old or young, your corpse can be of some use to medical science. There are, of course, extremely old or extremely young people far luckier than you whom a new surgical procedure or medical treatment could help keep alive. Once your screening is complete, your information is kept on file until the day you kick the bucket. Then, instead of going to a funeral home to be embalmed, your body is picked up by the agency you're registered to, who immediately gets to work on preserving your body without actually damaging it with harsh chemicals such as those used at funeral homes. When your body's prepared by a funeral home, a devil's brew of chemicals is used to make you appear lifelike as you rest in your coffin for a final farewell. You'll look the picture of perfect health, even though you're dead, and full of more chemicals than an American supermarket meat. You'll instead go to a freezer while you'll sometimes stay for up to 3 years, until the need arises. After that period, your remains will be cremated free of charge to your family, who can then do with your ashes as they like. If your family is even remotely cool, they'll have you made into a firework. However, if you fit the bill for any number of cadaver requests, you could go on to briefly live a second life in a number of exciting adventures. Your body could be used to practice robotic surgery, as in robots practicing to do the surgery, not practicing doing surgery on robots where you would be completely useless. With the advent of artificial intelligence and telemedicine, the field of robotic surgery is rapidly growing, and you could help pave the way for a future of surgical pods, like the one in the awful Alien movie starring Michael Fassbender. Actually, there's two of those at this point. Turns out people are super wary about letting robots hack away at their bodies, so corpses are perfect for letting our future Terminator overlords learn the best way to take apart the human body. You could also, however, end up helping a new surgeon learn his trade, or testing laser treatment for acne. That plague on your face may help keep other young teenagers from suffering the humiliation of adolescent pizza face. But if you're really lucky, you'll finally get to do something really cool with your body. The US military is in the business of politely asking people in other countries to stop doing things we don't like by blowing them up or shooting them full of holes. In order to advance the science of blowing people up or shooting them full of holes, occasionally the US military is in need of cadavers. And that's where you come in. You can help test new weapons by getting shot at. While ballistic gel molds can give us a lot of information about how new weapons perform by simulating human bodies, there's nothing quite like the real thing. Shooting up cadavers can allow military scientists to gather extremely accurate data on how to improve existing weapon designs or even how to help treat and save lives by those wounded by similar weapons. This is the case with the controversial US Army blast experiments, which have for years used corpses of all ages and sizes to test the effects of various explosives on the human body. One man in Arizona was shocked to discover that his dead mother, who had agreed to donate her body to science, had been used to test the effects of IEDs on the human body under various levels of protection. While her son was livid enough to take legal action, by all accounts his mother had a blast. This type of weapon testing is incredibly useful in both creating better weapons and helping protect our troops and save lives, even if it's not exactly the type of science most donors think they'll be helping advance. Some donation agencies allow a donor to opt out of any related testing. But due to the low number of donors, body brokers typically simply leave this possibility out of the brochure for prospective donors. Your body, however, could also be used in industry and government-run safety tests. Vehicle manufacturers may turn to the use of cadavers to test new safety features of a vehicle, or the government could order a round of crash tests using real human bodies to assess new safety procedures or regulations. These tests may sound garish to the still living, but they've helped save countless lives and prevented millions of crippling injuries. Perhaps most surprising of all about donating your body to science, though, is the fact that you're not likely to end up in one piece. Cadavers are frequently dismembered, as various customers need different body parts to experiment on or to complete their shrunken head collection. Your legs may go to a research facility working on new treatments for broken bones, while your hands go to a medical school so surgeons can practice reattaching severed fingers. While legally the donor facility is required to collect all of the remains after their use is over and hand over the cremated ashes to your family, we can realistically assume that there's not a snowball's chance in hell anybody has taken the time to gather up your remains from the far-flung corners of the US. Your family will likely instead receive ashes that are probably, maybe mostly you, along with a few bits of other strangers that they had lying around and needed to get rid of. Now go watch Funeral Home Secrets They Don't Want You to Know, or click this other video instead.